As indicated previously, stability is an important property that must be considered in any practical implementation of a system. We define an arbitrary lag system as BIBO, bounded input, bounded output, stable if and only if its output sequence YN is bounded for every bounded input XN. A linear time invariant system is stable if its impulse response is absolutely summable. This condition is not only sufficient, but it is also necessary to ensure that the stability of the system. For the causal system first, we note that the system is causal, where a single pole system described by this equation, Hn equal to A with the power of N multiplied with Un. This value is actually equal to this one, and we summarize in this equation. The geometric series converge provided that the magnitude of A less than 1. Else, meaning that magnitude of A larger than 1, else it will diverge. Therefore, for causal systems to be stable, magnitude of A must be less than 1. So that the Hn must decay exponentially towards 0 as n approach infinity for the system to be stable. For anti-causal system example, we have a single pole described by Hn with the power equal to B with the power of n, where n is less than 0. So for n less than 0, it must be started from negative infinity to negative 1. This is actually equal to this one. Okay, this equation, we assume that to be this one, where we replace 1 over magnitude B with beta. So beta is equal to this one, which is must be less than unity for the geometric series to converge. Consequently, the anti-causal system will be stable if magnitude of B larger than 1 are satisfied. So for further reading, you can refer to the monograph based on these following subchapters: discrete time system, recursive, non-recursive, and also classification of discrete time system. That's all. Thank you very much.